So now the question is, what causes inflammatory bowel disease? So our understanding has evolved over a period of time. So we understand that at the core of all this is your gut microbiome, your gut-friendly bacteria, and that microbiome plays an essential role. When that gets disrupted, when these healthy microbiomes are disrupted, we call the condition dysbiosis. And dysbiosis is central to this development of IBD. However, many things play a role in it. There is environment, and then there is genetics. So if you have tendency or predilection, or you have genetics that puts you at high risk, you don't necessarily develop IBD, but it puts you at high risk of it. But then the microbiome and the environment changes that process and makes you develop that condition. So the environment acts and your microbiome changes with your genetics, putting you at high risk, together give you the condition inflammatory bowel disease. And then it determines whether it can present in the form of Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. Genetics wise, the studies are still ongoing, but there are more than 350 regions in the genes that have been found in one way or the other to have connection with the inflammatory bowel disease. Another thing that we must note is that we always ask these patients, do you have any family member with autoimmune disease? Because those genes have been found in close proximity with the genes responsible for inflammatory bowel disease. So autoimmune diseases also puts you at higher risk of developing inflammatory bowel diseases. In the family where there is rheumatoid arthritis, where there is SLE or systemic lupus or other conditions, it can put you at high risk for it. Genetics have also shown that certain extra-intestinal manifestation, for example, in the liver, you can have a condition called PSC, or primary sclerosing cholangitis. What it means is that in the liver, you have small little ducts, and those ducts are very narrow in that condition, and that can lead you to develop liver disease. And those genes have also been found closer to the inflammatory bowel disease. And PSC has been found in association with ulcerative colitis. Similarly, with Crohn's disease, you can have skin condition called pyoderma, and also you can have erythema nodularis, which has like swellings in the shin area, very painful, and those can be associated with Crohn's disease as well. So environmental factors, of course, there is diet, very poor diet, ultra processed food, smoking, those have all been like our and sedentary lifestyle, of course, they all put you at high risk in disruptions in microbiome. And if you have the genetic predilection, you're going to develop one of these conditions.